is indeed the conditionality or rule of law as a conditionality for the budget. When I look at the different groups in the European Parliament, there is quite a lot of difference in terms of emphasis. Some groups, and of course you all know them, put a lot of emphasis on this, whereas other groups take it much less into account. So a compromise will have to be found. It will be a compromise of the overall compromise, so it is very difficult at this point in time on where we will land or where the Council will land on this point. I think it's fairly obvious that there needs to be something in it. How explicit it will be, how much restraint it will put on certain expenditures that will have to be made in terms of the recovery facility and, of course, the MFF, remains to be seen. I think this is one of the most delicate political discussions that will take place in the coming days and weeks up to the summit of July the 18th. But at this point in time, it's very hard for me to predict where that exactly will land in terms of the whole compromise on the recovery facility and on the MFF.
So my follow-up is you're saying that there are differences between groups, but also, I imagine, within groups in the European Parliament. And I'm thinking of the current cases that the EU has been forced to take against the Polish government, and because of its systematic demolition of its independent judiciary, and the Law and Justice Party, which is in government in Poland at the moment, is, well, the government that's brought this systemic demolition. So how difficult for you is it, as a member of this group, to see another member engage in this sort of damage, hopefully not permanent damage to the rule of law?
Well, I come from a country where the rule of law is strictly adhered to, and that's, of course, a principle that I take very highly in my, how should I say, political and even personal values, for that matter. So it's I have, of course, some... some questions with respect to what's happening in countries. You mentioned one, but there are others too, where there are issues with this rule of law. And of course, we all agree to the European treaties, in which there are quite specific elements in terms of rule of law and the respect for that. So the only thing I can hope is that everybody lives up to what is in these treaties and what the specific elements of rule of law are concerned. With respect to my own position within the ECR group, which you were referring to, and which, of course, is a very legitimate question, if you would check my voting record on this one, you will see that I indeed follow my personal instincts and personal convictions on this one. And luckily, the ECR group is organized in such a way that it is indeed allowed, between brackets, to take this liberty, which, of course, I'm not hiding this, gives rise to some lively internal discussions. But I think it's important that everybody can get up in the morning, look in the mirror and say, hello, how are you? I still like you. Which is something I do not every morning, but regularly.